Hello students, welcome for today's video lecture of Ganit Pravinya. Today we are going to solve the next examples in exercise 30. Okay, till yesterday we have learned first 5 examples of exercise 30. So today we will learn examples from 6 onwards. Okay, so open your exercise 13 of Ganit Pravinya. Put your finger on the problem number 6. I have a sum of rupees 33. It is in equal numbers of coins of denominations of 25 paise, 10 paise, 5 paise and 20 paise. How many coins of each kind are there? See, what does this question tell us? I have sum of rupees 33 means what? Sum means amount. I have total how many rupees? 33 rupees I have. How many? Rupees 33. Okay, rupees 33. And how these rupees are in the form of coins. In the form of coins. Coins of 25 paise, 10 paise, 5 paise and 20 paise. And the number of coins of each denominations. Each denominations means this 25 paise, 10 paise, 5 paise, 20 paise. These are called denominations of rupees, okay, or coins. Now see, I have equal number of coins. These 33 rupees which I have, they are in equal number of coins of these denominations. Okay, then how many coins of each kind are there? How many coins of each kind are there? Okay, that we have to find. So see now, equal number of coins of denominations. Twenty-five paise, 5 paise, 10 paise, 5 paise and 20 paise. Okay, means I have these 33 rupees which I have, they are in the form of the coins of 25 paise, 10 paise, 5 paise and 20 paise. Okay, have you seen 25 paise coin, 10 paise coin, 5 paise coin, 20 paise coin? I think you might have seen 25 paise coin. Okay. These are old coins which now we don't use. Paise, coin of paise now we don't use. We use coins from 1 rupees onwards. Okay. So, our grandfather, grandmother or father, mother, they were using these coins. 25 paise, 10 paise, 5 paise, 20 paise. Okay. So, I have rupees 33 which are in this form. 25 paise coin, 10 paise, 5 paise and 20 paise. And the condition is that I have equal number of coins of these 4. Equal number of coins means what? If there are 10 coins of 20 paise, then 10 coins of 10 paise, 5 coins of 5 paise, sorry, 10 coins of 5 paise and 10 coins of 20 paise. Same coins of each kind. Okay, then how many coins of each kind I have, which will make rupees 33. Understood? So for that, what we have to do to find that, what we have to do now, see, these coins are in paise, coins are in paise. Okay, so what, these rupees will convert into paise. So rupees 33 is equal to how many paise? Can you tell me? 1 rupee means how many paise? 1 rupee means 100 paise. So rupees 33 is equal to 33 multiplied by 100 paise, that is 3300 paise. 33 rupees means 3300 paise. Okay, now what to do, you know, to find the number of coins, to find the number of coins of each kind, first add the value of these coins. Add the value of these coins means number of coins is equal to, what we have to do to find number of coins, we have to divide this total value by value of this, sum of the value of this coin, that is 25 paise plus 10 paise plus 5 paise plus 20 paise. Understood what we have done? 3300 paise divided by this bar means divided by 25 paise plus 10 paise plus 5 paise plus 20 paise. Okay, so 3300 paise upon, let's add this, 25 plus 10 or 20 plus 10 30 and 25 plus 5 30, 30 plus 30 60 paise. Okay, this paise cut, this zero will cut for this zero. 330 divided by 6, what you will get? 6 5 are 30, 3 minus 0 3 are 3, 3 minus 3 0, 0 came down, again 30 is there, 6 5 are 30, 55. So there are 55 coins of each kind. There are 55 coins of 25 paise, 55 coins of 10 paise, 55 coins of 5 paise and 55 coins of 20 paise. Equal coins of each kind, okay? How to find in this, if the question is like this, is asked in the exam, what, how to find? Now see, these coins are in paise, so we have converted this total sum in the paise. If the coins would have been rupees, 1 rupees, 2 rupees, 5 rupees, then need not to change its unit, okay? It will remain as rupees only. Now these coins are given in paise, so we have converted this sum into paise. Understood? Then after converting, divide this value, total sum, by addition of the coin, value of coin, addition of value of coin, that is 3300 paise divided by addition of all the values of coin. Okay, so 3300 paise upon addition of this, addition of the value of the coin is, given coin is 60. So we divided and we got answer 55. That means the coins of each kind are 55. Okay, next, example number 7. Convert 3 hours 119 minutes 3 hours 190 minutes 136 second into hours, minute and second. We have to convert these 3 hours 190 minute and 136 second into hours, minute and second. So what is different then? These are whatever given, it is also hours, minute and second. Then why to convert? These are not given in any other units. Okay. For example, if there something is given in meter and we convert that into kilometer, then this and this unit is different. But here they have given in hours, minute and second, and again they are asking to convert into hours, minute and second. What is difference there? Yes, it is there. What we are going to change? See, there are 136 seconds. You know, 60 second makes 1 minute. If yesterday Dinde ma'am has taught you, 60 second make 1 minute, and there are 136 second. So here in this 136 second, something are minute. Means 60 second will convert into minute. Okay, and whatever second will remain, which will be less than 60, that will remain in second. Again, minutes are there. Minutes also, you know, 60 minutes make 1 hour. So 60 minutes will take carry in the hours. So that there will be 1 hour or two or whatever group of 60 we will get. Okay? So that we are going to do. First we will take second, 136 second. There are 136 second. Okay? Now you know that 60 second makes 1 minute. 60 second is equal to 1 minute. So in there are 136 second is equal to, let's divide 136 by 60. divide, when we divide by 60 means what? We make group of 60-60. So how many groups we will get? That will be your quotient or that will be your minutes. Okay? Now see, let's divide 136 by 60. You know table of 60? 6, 12, 18, 24 and put just 0, 0. Okay, now there is 136. 61 is a 60 or 62 is a 120 or 63 is a 180. 62 is a 120. 6, 1, 0. Okay. Now see here, when we divided 136 second by 60, that means when we made group of 136 second into 60-60, how many groups are possible? 2. That means 2 groups of 60. And 16 second left. That is 60 plus 60, 120 and 16, 136. Okay. So this 60 second means one group means 1 minute. And this 60 second means 1 minute. So we have got here 2, that means 2 minutes. Okay, and this whatever is left back, this they are second. Understood? So here 136 second is equal to 2 minutes and 16 second. Okay. Now let's take minute here, 119 minutes. Same here, you know, 60 minutes make 1 hour. 60 minutes is equal to 1 hour, correct? So here also we will divide this 119 by 60. So what we will get? 61 is 60 or 1 minute. You know, there are 119 minutes, okay? And these 2 minutes, which we have converted from second to minutes, from this 136 second, we have got these 2 minutes that will take carry here. And we will add in these 119 minutes, okay? So 119 plus 2, 121 minutes. Understood? Now this 121 minutes will be divided by 60. Now you know that 60 minutes means 1 hour. So 121 minutes we will divide into group of 60. And 121 divided by 60. 120 is there. 2s are 120. Okay. 1 minus 0, 1. 2 minus 2, 0, 0. Now see, when we divided 121 minutes into group of 60, we got two groups. 60, 60, 60, 60, 120 and 1 minute left, correct? So this 60 minute means 1 hour, this 60 minute means 1 hour. So these 2 hours we have got here. And this 1 left, no, remainder, that is minutes. Okay, so 121 minutes is equal to 2 hours, 1 minute. This 1 minute will be your final, group final. Okay. Now see, there are how many hours? 3 hours. There are 3 hours. And plus, these 2 hours will be counted in these 3 hours. So there will be, finally there will be how many hours? 5 hours. Understood? See. 3 hours, 190 minutes, 136 seconds. It was given. Again, we have regrouped them. We have regrouped. We have arranged again. Okay, we converted these seconds, some minutes were there that we to carry in the minutes column. Again, from the minute column, there were some hours that we took carry in the hours column. So, finally, we have got 5 hours. 5 hours, 1 minute and how many seconds? 16 seconds. Okay? In this way we have to regroup them. Now pause this video, write this in your notebook. See here problem number 8. Write down rupees 51 एंड 5 पैसे एज एन इम्प्रॉपर फ्रैक्शन. रुपीज 51 एंड 5 पैसे वी हैव टू राइट एज अ इम्प्रॉपर फ्रैक्शन. अंडरस्टूड? यू नो इम्प्रॉपर फ्रैक्शन मीन्स व्हाट? हुज न्यूमरेटर इज ग्रेटर देन इट्स डिनोमिनेटर. न्यूमरेटर इज ग्रेटर, डिनोमिनेटर इज स्मॉलर. सच इम्प्रॉपर फ्रैक्शन वी हैव टू राइट. सो रिमेंबर हियर, डोंट राइट 51 इज ग्रेटर देन 5 पैसे, सो 51 अपॉन 5. Don't write like this. How to write? See, yes, 51 is rupees and 5 is paise. Okay, how to write? Rupees 51 and 5 paise. Okay, so this rupees 51 and 5 paise, first we will write in the form of decimal. So rupees 51 and 5 paise, if you want to write in the form of decimal, it will come like this. Rupees 51.5 paise. Okay? Rupees 51.05. If you write it as a 5 paise, here only 5, then it will be 50 paise. Okay? So write in this way, 05. Rupees 51.05. Understood? Now this we will convert into first fraction. So 51.05, this is suppose decimal number, and how we convert decimal number into fraction? We convert this way. Without first we write without decimal point, write whole number and write 1 below the 1 in the denominator, and see after decimal point how many digits are there? 2 digits are there. So put 2 zeros, okay? So here we have 5105 upon 100. Is it improper fraction? Yes, this is improper fraction. Further, we can find the reduced term also. See, both 5105 and 100 are divisible by which number? Means both numerator and denominator are divisible by 5. See, last digit is 5, here 0, that means they are divisible by 5. So we can find its reduced term. Sometimes what we know, the options which will be given, in that option this answer will not be given. There will be different answer. So that will be the reduced form of this answer. This is also correct, but they will give answer in the reduced form, smallest term, okay? So we have to divide both numerator and denominator by same number to find the reduced term. You know that. So 5 1s are 5, 5 0s are 0, 5 2s are 10, 5 1s are 5, and 100 divided by 5 is 5 2s are 10 and 5 0s are 0. 1021 upon 20. If you are not able to do division here on this spot, take separately 5105 and divide it by 5. You will get 1021. And 100 divided by 5, you will get 20. Okay? So this is the improper fraction for rupees 51 and 5 paise. Next, example number 9. Write down 7 years and 3 months as a mixed number and decimal fraction. So first, 9, 7 years and 3 months. We have to write as a mixed fraction or mixed number, mixed fraction, okay? So how to write? Whenever we write mixed fraction, see, mixed fraction for this will be, you know, whenever we write mixed fraction, one part is here and here there is fractional part. This is called a whole part. This is called whole part, complete part, and here fractional part we write. So in this 7 years and 3 months, what is whole part? Can you imagine, can you guess what is whole part? You know, here there is years and months. Here complete part is years and months means it is incomplete year. Okay, so here whole part is 7 years. And incomplete part means fractional part is 3 months. 3 months means not complete year, it is part of year. You know, 3 months means 3 we will write here. Then what we will write in the denominator? 3 out of how many? 3 months out of how many? You know, in 1 year, how many months are there? 12 months. So, these 3 months out of 12 months. 12 months makes 1 year. So, here 3 months are given, that means 3 out of 12 are given. So, it will be like this, 7 whole, that is 7 years, 3 upon 12. 3 out of 12. Okay? Now, the next is decimal fraction. Again, this we have to convert into decimal fraction. Okay? So, how to convert into decimal fraction? 7 whole, 3 upon 12. How to convert into decimal fraction? First, let us convert into improper fraction. That is 7 into 12 plus 3 upon 12. So, 12 sevens are 84 plus 3. 84 plus 3? 87. Okay? Upon 12 is equal to. Now, 87 upon 12. This fraction we have to convert into decimal number. We know how to convert. Let's divide 87 by 12. So, it is 12 sevens are 84. 3 remain 0. Put your decimal point. Then, take 0 here. 12 twos are 24. Two. 10 minus 4 is 6, 0. Again, there is denominator 6, so we'll give 0 after it. 12 5s are 16. So it is 7.25. 7.25. This is the decimal fraction for 7 whole 3 upon 12. Understood? Watch again if you don't understand. 10th one. See a 10th one example. How much amount will be realized by selling 8 dozen chikus at Rs. 12.50 per dozen? 8 dozen chikus are to be sold and cost of chikus per dozen. Okay, see, cost of chikus per dozen. Per dozen means per one dozen chiku. Cost is Rs. 12.50. Means 12 rupees and 50 paise. Okay? Then we have to find how many chikus we have to sell? 8 dozen. So we have to find cost of 8 dozen chikus. What will be the cost of 8 dozen chikus? Okay? So what to do? Given for 1, per dozen means 1 dozen, asking for 8. What to do? Multiplication, right? So 12.50 multiplied by 8. Let's multiply. 8 zeros are 0. 8 fives are 40. 0 will come down, 4 will be carried. 8 twos are 16. 16 plus 4. 20, 0 will come down, 2 will be carried. 8 ones are 8 plus 2, 10. Where will be decimal point? Here, see, after decimal point, 2 digits are there. So, we put decimal point in the answer before 2 digits from the back. 1, 2 here. So, rupees. So, cost of 8 dozen chikus. Is rupees 100 means 100 rupees 00 paise. Okay, got it? Pause this video, write this in your notebook. Now see next one. Question number 11. In a certain place, two rings
18 quires and 16 sheets of paper were printed in a day. So how many sheets were printed?
How many sheets were printed? 2 reams. 2 reams, 18 quires. And 16 sheets. Okay, so yesterday Dinde ma'am has given you the conversion of the reams into quires, or sheets into quires, quires into reams, sheets into reams. You know what is this? These are the units to measure sheets of paper. These are the units to measure sheets of paper. If you have gone in the press, you know, press means where invitation cards of wedding or something, invitation card of any function are printed. That is called printing press. Okay, printing press. So there, sheets of paper are used to printing. And here they have, see, in one day, 2 reams, 18 quires and 16 sheets are used. This much sheets are used in that printing press in that one day, in the one day, okay? So, this total, the sheets which are given in the form of, in the units of reams, quires and sheets, this we have to convert into total sheets of paper. Understood? All these, here sheets are given in 3 units, reams, quires and sheets, and we have to convert them into only one unit, that is sheets. Okay? So now, you know that, first we will convert your reams. 2 reams. Okay, now you know, 1 ream means how many sheets of paper? 1 ream means how many sheets of paper? 480 sheets. 1 ream means 480 sheets. So there are 2 reams. So, 2 reams means how many? 2 into 480. That is, which is equal to 2 zeros are 0, 2 8s are 16, 1 carry, 2 4s are 8 and 1, 9 sheets. So 960 sheets. 2 reams means 960 sheets. Okay, then quires. There are 18 quire sheets. So let's convert 18 quire sheets into sheets. Okay, 18 quires. So you know, 1 quire means how many sheets? 1 quire means how many sheets of paper? This should be memorized. This should be, you know this. Okay, you should know this. Okay? So 1 quire means 24 sheets. Make a chart of these units and paste in your study room. Make a chart of all these units and paste in your study room so that every day you will read that and try to memorize. Understood? So 1 quire means 24 sheets. Then, so 18 quires means how many sheets? 18 quires is equal to 18 into 24. That is, 18 fours are 72, 7 carry, 18 twos are 36 and 7, 43, 432 sheets. And these are 16 sheets only, okay? So, 2 reams means 960 sheets, 18 quires means 432 sheets, and these 16 sheets will add together. So total sheets is equal to 960 plus 432 plus 16. It is equal to 6 plus 2, 8, 8 plus 0, 8. 1 plus 3, 4, 4 plus 6, 10, 0 will come down, 1 will be carried, 9 plus 1, 10 and 4, 14, 9 plus 1, 10, 10 and 4, 14, for 1,408 sheets are used in that day, okay, so, on that day 1408 sheets were used, sheets of paper were used. Got it? Next, 12th one.
In a hostel, 3 gross, 5 dozen bananas were required for distribution among children, 1 each. How many dozen bananas were distributed? So, how many bananas were required every day? 3 gross and 5 dozen.
3 gross and 5 dozen bananas were required to distribute among the students. This much students were there in that hostel. So each one was given 1 banana. So this much bananas were required. That means how many bananas were required? Or how many dozen bananas were required? What they have asked? How many dozen bananas were distributed? Now see, your bananas are given in gross and dozen, and they have asked in how many dozen. That means this we need to convert into dozen. Okay, 3 gross and 5 dozen is total how many dozen? So here first we will convert this 3 gross into dozen. Okay. Now you know 1 gross means how many dozen? 1 gross means how many dozen? It is also given yesterday. 1 gross. These are the units. Gross, dozen. These are the units to measure the objects, articles like bananas or eggs or what we can say apples. If there are 12 apples, that means there are 1 dozen apples. Mangoes, 12 mangoes means 1 dozen mangoes. Eggs, 1 dozen eggs means 12 eggs. Understood? So these are the gross, dozen are the units to measure these objects or articles. Okay? You know, 1 dozen means 12 articles, 12 objects. Likewise, 1 gross means how many dozen? 1 gross means how many dozen? 1 gross means 12 dozen. 12 dozen makes 1 gross. You know, 12 objects make 1 dozen. 12 dozen makes 1 gross. Understood? So here there are 3 gross. So 3 gross is equal to how many dozen? 1 gross means 12 dozen. Then 3 gross means how many dozen? 3 into 12. That is 12 threes are 36 dozen. Okay, so total bananas in dozen are how many? This 3 gross means 36 dozen and plus 5, that is 41 dozen. So 41 dozen bananas were required to distribute in that hostel. Understood? Next. Now see next. Pause this video now. Write these 2 questions in notebook. After that we'll see one more problem number 13. Okay. See now problem number 13. A dozen notebook means 1 dozen notebooks cost rupees 52.80. That is cost of a dozen notebooks is what? How many rupees? 52 rupees. Rupees 52.80. Okay? That means rupees 52 0.80 rupees 52.80 means 52 rupees and 80 paise. Okay, what is the price of each notebook? So cost means price, cost of each notebook we have to find. What given for a dozen? A dozen, now see, a dozen means how many notebooks? A dozen means actually how many notebooks? 12 notebooks. Understood? So cost of, this is the cost of 12 notebooks, and we have to find cost of each notebook, means one notebook, each one of 12 notebooks. Okay, so which operation you have to do here? Given for many, asking for one, division, right? So rupees 52.80 we have to divide by 12. A dozen, see, they have not given 12, they have given a dozen. So you should know here that a dozen means 12 notebooks. So we have to divide, to find cost of each notebook, we have to divide this total price by 12. Okay, so now see, there is 52 divided by 12, 52, first we will divide to 52 by 12. 12 4s are 48. 2 minus 8, not possible. So it will become 12, and here even 4. 12 minus 8, 4, and 4 minus 4, 0. So see, the number before decimal point was 52, that we have divided 52. Now we are going to come after decimal point. So before that, what we have to do? Your decimal point completed, so here in the quotient, put decimal point. Then take next digit down. 48, 12 4s are 48. 8 minus 8, 0, 0. 0 remain, take it down. 12 zeros are 0. Understood what we have done? How we have given this decimal point? Here, see, before decimal point there was 52. So in the first step only we divided 52. 12 4s are 52. Here, that number before decimal point is completed in the first step. So before dividing this, taking this digit down, put decimal point in the quotient. So this is the cost of each notebook. So cost of each notebook is rupees 4.40. That is 4 rupees and 40 paise. 4 rupees and 40 paise. That is rupees 4.40. Okay. So today we have discussed, or we have solved the problems from 6 to 13. If you have any doubt in this, ask during the doubt session. Okay. Thank you and have a nice day.